Hello and welcome to coverage of Grand Prix Seattle-Tacoma. I'm Marshall Sutcliffe in the booth with Hall of Famer William Huey Jensen. And it is time for the finals. It's been a long road for these players, but they are ready to do battle. And we've got a really cool matchup here, Huey. We've got Jarvis Yu playing lands against Christian Calcano on Grixis Delver, kind of the newest version of Delver, yep. If you want to, you know, put them in chronological order here. Now, break this matchup down for us a little bit here, Huey. What are these two decks trying to do?
The Grixis Delver mostly is playing a one-for-one tempo game. With the exception of Young Pyromancer, every card in the deck just trades card for card. What it's trying to do is play a tempo game. It's trying to put a very cheap threat into play, something like Delver of Secrets, Deathrite Shaman, Gurmag Angler, that's a cheap threat somehow.
It is. It's cost of mana.
And it's going to use Wastelands and Stifles to just keep everything the opponent can do at bay, prevent them from getting more than one or two mana, and try to win quickly and finish the game off with Lightning Bolts or things like that. Jarvis, on the other hand, is trying to just kind of go crazy. He's trying to use Life from the Loam to delve, put a bunch of lands into play, cast Mana Bond, throw his hand on the table, and ultimately use Dark Depths and Thespian Stage to make a 20/20 Merit Lage token, or sometimes grind out a longer game with cards like Maze of Ith and Tabernacle to keep his opponent's creatures at bay, and Punishing Fire to slowly chip away at the life
total. One at a time.
Yeah.
All right, well, we see a quick first turn here for you. He plays his deck very quickly here, and he goes Thespian Stage, Mox Diamond, discarding Maze of Ith, and then gets it back by playing Life from the Loam,
sure.
Which also, of course, gets it in the graveyard.
So we see with the Gitaxian Probe that Jarvis has Crop Rotation in hand, which means he's close. He's close. He can crop rotate for Dark Depths. He needs two more mana to activate the Thespian Stage, but we're talking almost next turn.
Okay.
Except for the fact his Loam got countered and Maze of Ith doesn't tap for mana.
Right, and this is like, that's kind of desperation though, right, from Calcano? Like, countering Life from the Loam is not a good long-term strategy.
Right, no.
Wow, so Jarvis Yu actually putting out a very threatening board early on in the game, and also has a Maze of Ith just to make sure he doesn't take damage here.
Right.
Now, Wasteland can certainly mess that up, but again, this Life from the Loam thing, keeping the cards coming.
Maze of Ith keeps the Delver at bay. Calcano has no lands in play because of the days, but he really didn't have much of a choice.
Right. And here's Ponder.
But like we talked about before the game, you can imagine if that Delver Secrets had been a Deathrite Shaman, how much better off Calcano is.
Right.
Life from the Loam, days it, untapped, exile
it. Eat it.
Yeah, eat the lands, eat the loam, the Punishing Fire in the graveyard.
Yeah, this feels like an uphill battle in the early stages here for Calcano.
Well, Jarvis has multiple copies of Maze of Ith. Calcano can't even get through for damage until he has three creatures. He can use Wasteland to, like, buy a turn against the combo by killing the Thespian Stage, or kill one Maze of Ith for one turn. But ultimately, where does that get you? He's still loaming and loaming and loaming.
And we'll note here that Jarvis is at 20. I mean,
oh yeah,
like this is all just to chip in for a little bit of damage.
Jarvis
has life to give here.
Like, Calcano's going to have to try to win this game with the Deathrite Shaman.
Right.
Now he's force of willing Life from the Loam. It's like, it's you can see how up against it he is already. It's turn three, and Jarvis is dredging a spell that Calcano has to counter every turn.
Now this is interesting. Young Pyromancer can go wide enough so that the Mazes of Ith don't get the job done. And then, you know, we start thinking about a card like Tabernacle.
Sort of, except we know about the Punishing Fire. So does Calcano from the Gitaxian Probe in Jarvis's hand. Jarvis doesn't care enough to even bother trying to kill it. He's just trying to get the Grove of the Burn Willows to keep everything stable. And Calcano, for the third turn in a row, dazes the Life from the Loam that Jarvis dredged.
He's trying. Here's another Ponder to make another elemental token.
One interesting thing is, it's relatively clear that Jarvis has no more lands in his hand.
Mm-hmm.
I think Calcano actually even knows both his cards. So if he can find a wasteland for that Thespian stage, Jarvis can't dredge Loam because he can't cast it. So it forces him to draw off the top. And maybe he has, like, some bad draws at that point. Maybe you can get lucky. Like, maybe he draws another life from the Loam. Or
maybe he has, like, 38 lands in his
Yeah, that's a problem. But maybe he draws another life from the Loam. Mm-hmm. Or maybe he just draws a Dark Depths.
Sure.
Or, you know, another Punishing Fire. Or a Gamble or whatever. You got to try something.
Yeah, for sure. Let's see if Jarvis can put together a win here. We see that Calcano's building out his board.
Oh, he has the Wasteland.
He does have
he
the Wasteland.
He thought about playing something else. I don't know what it was, but I like this play.
He's going to only get in for one damage here.
Take one. Got to start somewhere.
Yeah, those untap, this Jarvis tells him. What does Jarvis find here?
He found an Exploration. That's what I'm talking about. That's one of the worst draws in his deck.
Now, is he going to crop rotate away one of these Mazes of Ith?
He might have to.
He does.
Yeah.
I mean, this gets him the ability to get it back down the line anyway with Loam, right?
Right. He can get it back with Loam, and at least now he has two mana to cast the spells in his hand. I mean, the important spell, which is Punishing Fire, the Loam from his graveyard.
Oh, he's going to go for Tabernacle here.
Oh, yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah, that's pretty good. What a move.
Yeah. So it's like Calcano's in the spot now where he can pay one to keep one creature versus Maze of Ith.
Mm-hmm.
You're not going to get anywhere like that.
No.
And Calcano is just conceding.
He's done. Jarvis Yu making sure that those cards were being scooped up, but that means that Jarvis Yu is one game away from being our champion, and it's going to be on Calcano to win back-to-back games against this grindy lands deck if he's going to be our champ here.
Yeah, and Calcano doesn't have a ton to sideboard in. It looks like two Surgical Extraction, which are good. That can get the Loam. That can get a
Punishing
specific
Fire.
Land that's being targeted by Loam. It can get Punishing Fire. One Pithing Needle, name Maze of Ith. It could name Thespian Stage. And probably like one Sulfuric Vortex just to have a clock.
Yeah.
It's like a 2-2 unblockable creature in a sense that
it
doesn't get Maze of Ith and doesn't have to get paid for by Tabernacle.
Right, and you know, and we've seen that, by the way. Jarvis has played at two distinctly different speeds. We've seen him win on turn three or whatever, you know, making Merit Lage. But we've also seen him go into a much longer game plan where he's constantly dredging and replaying Life from the Loam, keeping his opponent off of mana with Wastelands, and then eventually finding a way to either get that Merit Lage token or to Punishing Fire. And if he's going to take that super long stance, you know, a card like Sulfuric Vortex could get him before it's
right, and that's really the power of the lands deck. It can play like a mid-range deck, it can like a mid-range-ish control deck, and it can play like a combo deck. And we've seen two games in a row completely different strategies from Jarvis.
I'm really curious to see if we do get a Surgical Extraction in hand.
Yeah,
and what it does.
It'll definitely be boarded in.
It'll be in the deck for sure.
I wonder about Cabal Therapy. I wonder if somehow the combination of Cabal Therapy and Surgical Extraction to just like spike the Punishing Fires so he can ride a Deathrite Shaman or something like that could possibly be worth it.
No, that makes a lot of sense. Getting rid of the getting rid of the Punishing Fire so that your Deathrites stay around can really wreck what Jarvis is doing.
And I mean, look at the sideboard for Jarvis. Caracas, no. Bajuka Bug, no. Crossing Grip, no. Molten Vortex, no. Sphere Resistance, no. Choke, okay.
Sure.
Chalice of the Void. Look how many one cast and cost cards are in Calcano's deck.
Most of them. Right?
28 cards of a 60-card deck. Countered.
All right, so we'll bring that in.
Yeah, we'll bring that one in. He has no way to remove it. If it doesn't get countered, that's just half his cards he draws he can just throw in the air.
That's
I mean, I guess he can use them as lotus petals for a Gourmet Gangler.
Well, players are going to sideboards here, and it looks like, they've each got something lined up for the other. It's been a fun weekend.
Yeah, it has.
It was nice having you in the booth.
Thank you. Maybe we'll do it again sometime.
Yeah.
I enjoyed it. Legacy is a fun format. to play and to watch.
Yeah, you know, I was talking with Ian about it in the semis, and we were looking at the decks that made it to the semis. So it's these two decks that we just talked about, but also Miracles,
yeah.
You know, the countertop deck, and Reanimator.
Yeah.
I mean, these decks just have almost nothing in common with the way they approach the games, the cards they use to get the job done. And, you know, it's really helped showcase part of why Legacy is so important to the people that love Legacy. You know, Legacy community is tight-knit, awesome group of people that truly love their format. And I love these GPs.
I mean, if
this
think
is like
about
a celebration
it,
for
we
them.
Have this Miracles deck that effectively wins with an artifact and an enchantment. Then we have this deck that's winning with lands. Then we have the Grixis Delver deck that wins with creatures. And the Reanimator deck also wins with creatures, but it's not the same thing. You know what I mean? It wins with spells, sort of.
One mana versus eight mana creatures.
Right, exactly.
Yeah, we saw in the semis, Calcano brought in that Surgical Extraction against Reanimator, and oh boy.
Oh, yeah.
He got him.
I was watching that. I wasn't in the booth, obviously, but that game was... You know, he goes for the Exhum, he gets Gristlebrand Surgical, then eats the Iona, gets another death right back. It was brutal.
Yeah, the end result on the Exhum was that Hapless Researcher came into play.
Yeah. And Death Right Shaman came into play.
For Chase, and then Calcano got a death right. Didn't work out exactly how he planned it. Like a little social time for our two finalists here.
Yeah, that's all right. You're allowed to enjoy playing.
Totally. Take your time, gentlemen. We'll be here.
You could tell they were having fun in the first game when Jarvis was taunting the calculator with Maze of Ith.
With Maze of Ith, yeah. Yeah. By the way, this is GP Top 8 number 7 for Christian Calcano.
Pretty good.
And he's actually won 2 GPs.
2 so far?
2 so far. This could be number 3, but he's got to win 2 back-to-back games to do it.
Is that another multiple Maze of Ith hand for Jarvis? I think it is.
Confirm. Is it?
Yeah.
Okay.
The third and the sixth card?
Yeah, I see now. He's also got a port. A Mox Diamond. There's that Punishing Fire as well.
Right.
And the Grove sitting right next to it in hand.
Knowing about Punishing Fire could conceivably make Calcano's turn one play much more difficult. If he was just planning to run out of Death Right Shaman, and it's like, ooh, maybe I need to hold this around until I can draw...
Yeah.
A surgical or
yeah.
Or a therapy in a surgical or a second death right shaman or something to that effect.
Yeah, and it probably happened to this Delver. I mean, remember Jarvis has a Mox Diamond here too, so he can just fire off a Punishing Fire right now if he
can
wants.
Can and probably will.
Yeah.
I mean, there's also an argument for just throwing Maze of Ith into
maze
play.
And be like, go for it, yeah. Jarvis is going to play Port plus Diamond.
Play around days.
That's right. Remember, Mox Diamond is a spell that's on the stack, and it can be interacted with as such. The good news is that you only have to discard if it resolves.
There's a period of time where that wasn't true.
Is that right? Yeah. Oh, God. Ugh. That's scary. And Jarvis is going to pass, and he's going to go for the mana denial route here. You know, he's not that worried about taking 1 or 3 damage, and he'd rather just shut down the land here on upkeep of Christian Calcano.
Certainly reasonable.
All right, let's trigger this thing, says Calc. Oh, and he hits. This is Ponder. All right, so make it 3. And I think that Calc just passed.
Did he? Well, he's definitely attacking first.
Yeah, he's obviously attacking. Okay, never mind. I saw something wrong. My bad. Here comes Ponder, and things looking pretty good for Calcano in the early stages here. Turn 1, Delver, flip it. Land, Ponder, even after getting ported, is about as good as you can expect here.
Well, he's got... He looks like he pondered into a Pithing Needle.
Interesting.
And a Deathrite Shaman.
Yeah, I saw the Shaman as well.
But he needs a plan to deal with that Punishing Fire. Pithing Needle stops a lot, but it doesn't stop Punishing Fire, and it doesn't stop Grove of the Burn Willows.
No, those are triggered abilities, so... Jarvis not playing around days this time, but gets the job done here. And Delver of Secrets falls, so that's a big stage there.
I can't see Calculator's hand, but here's where he needs the Surgical.
Totally.
At end of turn, Jarvis is going to try to return that Punishing Fire.
He's going to tap it for red, gain the life, get it back. And that's where Calculator wants to say, I have a response.
Yeah.
Oh, he might find it here. Here's Brainstorm. So Calc's resolving Brainstorm here. While Jarvis U patiently awaits, Jarvis is up a game here.
Patiently. It's just so tough if you're Calcano to maneuver through all this.
Oh, yeah. And that turn one Gitaxian Probe showed him some pretty bad news, too.
Yeah.
I mean, he definitely has a lot of work to do if he's going to pick up this game. But he does seem to be moving forward at a reasonable clip here. Again, he's hitting
maybe
this land.
Maybe if this
drop.
Is an Angler, maybe Angler untap Needle your Mazavith.
There you go.
Jarvis has a good draw, but he does not have much of a clock.
Yeah, this is just really tough. Now, this is huge because if Calcano had it, he doesn't. And these are just... This is just fresh meat sitting out there for the Punishing Fire here.
Yeah, just fodder.
Just...
Yep.
Well, two for two. And it looks like Jarvis is going to go ahead and just get the Punishing Fire back right now in Calcano's upkeep. You know, I got to say, it's not fun to be on Calcano's team if you're one of his creatures, because they are just getting thrown out to the slaughter.
Here. I mean,
yeah. I don't know what he can do else.
He's going to needle the maze, and he's just kind of try to, like, attrition through losing a creature every turn. That's his plan right now. That's the best he's got.
Yep. He's working with what he's got. It's a tough sell. Hoping to find one of these sideboard cards. And yeah,
I guess he didn't have the needle. Maybe he shuffled it away or something.
Okay. Yeah, and he's just going to pass the turn back here.
There's Dark Depths. But without the stage in hand, I don't think Jarvis can afford to cast it at the moment.
He just needs to keep.
This is a little. I mean, this is
on.
A lot of pressure.
It is.
Like,
it is.
He sort of has to kill Deathrite Shaman.
That means that he's taking four damage.
I guess
here.
He doesn't have to kill it yet. He can just return this right now and kill Deathrite Shaman next.
Right.
I guess with two Mazaviths, he's taking one.
He's taking a single point of damage
here?
Yeah,
after all that work.
Goodness sakes. I mean, this is ponder brainstorm. I mean, he is seeing a lot of cards. Oh, he
found it.
Yeah, he found the surgical extraction.
He's still going to lose the Death Rite Shaman to it.
Because right now it's currently sitting in Jarvis'
hand. It's in Jarvis'
hand,
yeah.
Passes back the turn. Like you said, the Death Rite, though, it's just a little too late here for him to save it.
Well, Surgical will take care of the Punishing Fires.
Still got a lot to worry about
here. He does have a lot to worry about.
Jarvis has a Light from the Loam in his hand. Only the one red mana source that's not tied up being a Grove of the Burn Willows.
It doesn't really, to be honest, even take care of it unless Jarvis tries to return it.
Yeah.
Like, if Jarvis is anticipating the surgical extraction, although he's probably not, because Calculator would have had to have just drawn it.
Exactly.
But, you know, now that he has two Maze of Iths and he's only taking one, he could just wait and try to find another Grove. He's got a Loam in his hand.
So then he would activate Grove, surgical, activate Grove again. Though it does look like he's going to open the door here for Calcano. Surgical your Punishing Fire. And you know, Jarvis knows, all right, well, he found it.
Yeah.
You know, he played a bunch of cantrips.
Right.
It's going to happen.
I killed six creatures with it.
Yeah, fair enough. But it does take away a very potent tool here from Jarvis. This is stage one here for Calcano. He's got a long way to go. But getting rid of that Punishing Fire means that any future Deathrite Shamans he draws are going to be alive and well.
Right. If Calcano could find a needle, like, right now to needle those mazes, he'd be in pretty good shape.
Yeah.
As it stands, he's only getting through for a damage a turn. Jarvis, with two copies of Dark Depths in his hand, too, can find a Thespian stage. And
we know how that goes. You know, interestingly, we also saw Jarvis U earlier in the day. Just do it the good old-fashioned way with Dark Depths, just like R&D drove and wrote it up. He was just paying mana.
Yep.
Got the job done that way.
Gamble. Well, you can gamble right now.
Yeah.
I gamble for Thespian stage.
Yeah, he's got Life from the Loam in his hand.
Oh,
can't
I discarded
lose.
It. I'll Life from the Loam it. Dark Depths, go.
Can't lose this particular gamble. Yeah, this is super tough for Calcano. And we haven't even seen a Wasteland yet out of Jarvis, but if he finds one, it's just every turn he mows down Calcano's mana as well. All right, here we go. Life from the Loam. Start things off. Oh. Taking it a little easy here. I don't know why you wouldn't.
I'm not sure.
I mean, he's not in a situation where he's under any big pressure, but I don't really see the downside either.
It's possible he didn't want to gamble away his Thicket because it protects his Loam.
Okay.
Like, as long as he has Thicket in his hand, he can cycle in response to surgical extraction, protect his Loam if Calcano randomly found the other one. And he probably feels he's under such little pressure that single risk might not be worth it.
Fair. I mean, he is taking one whole damage per turn currently.
Yeah, down to 11.
Mm-hmm. just life totals, making sure that those are up to date. Now, there's another life from Loam A and B. He'll know, right? He'll know now. Okay. Loam safe.
Yes.
Time to gamble. He also found a wasteland through the dredge, but
sure.
I don't think he needs it at this point. Jarvis Yu is closing in on a Grand Prix victory here with lands.
Reducing the clock to zero with a third Maze of Ith.
Right. And Jarvis just going to pass the turn again. Playing the patient game here. Land off the top for Calcano.
It is kind of funny that Calcano has Submerge for Merrill Age.
Does he?
Yeah. In hand.
Huh. Does he have like five Submerges in hand? Because Jarvis can just keep doing it, right?
Well, he only has two in his list, so.
So not five. All right.
Not five.
Noted. All right, here we go, Jarvis. Plays Thespian Stage, then plays Gamble. So Gamble's going to let him
gamble
tutor
for
up
Molten
a card.
Vortex.
Is that what it was?
That's what it was.
Going for style points here? Now one of these cards is going to get discarded at random.
Have you gambled much in your Magic career?
I actually played Aggro Loam
okay.
before, so I have resolved a gamble or two in my time. It's a good card.
It is a good card. Especially when you don't care where the card goes. Like where the graveyard's as good as the hand.
Oh, yeah. Have you? I mean, tell me you didn't gamble.
Just
tell me you didn't gamble it.
I haven't gambled much in my Magic career.
All right. All right, what did he discard? Well, whatever. There's Molten Vortex plus multiple Loams going, and he's just going to start chucking lands around here. He discarded a wasteland to it.
He is going to be attacking on a lot of axes now. Oh, Calcano had the Force Will for the Vortex.
All right.
Well, that's fine. We'll just start making 2020s. I mean,
yeah, it's the thing. I just don't think Jarvis, like everything that Calcano's been able to do is just sort of shrugged from Jarvis.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, okay.
I still think if Calcano found a needle like right now,
crunch.
Needle, Maze of Ith, get in for five.
Do something.
Next turn, he's dead.
Yeah. He's got one needle on the sideboard.
Yeah, but he had it. Remember early in the game, he pondered into it. He must have shuffled it away, but... But if he can find it again...
Now, Calcano has a wasteland here. Does that delay things at all as far as that combo goes?
I think it
does.
Can
he interrupt it?
I think if Jarvis... Thespian stages targeting Dark Depths, Calcano can wasteland the Thespian stage in response, so it never becomes a Dark Depths, and neither of them ever get sacrificed.
Yeah, now that's a delay tactic rather than a permanent solution, though, thanks to Life from the Loam, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
But he can also delay with the Submerge.
Mm-hmm.
So Jarvis makes his Thespian stage into a Rashadan port.
Yeah, it seems that precious few cards actually matter now from Calcano's side of the equation here. Stifle.
On what?
Don't know. Also, there's a Riftstone portal in the graveyard.
So those Maze of Ifs can...
They tap for
they
mana.
They tap for mana.
Green or white. You can choose.
Yeah.
Land go here. And things are looking good for Jarvis Yu. They have for a long time. He has not gone for Dark Depth Thespian stage to make up Merit Leash. At least he hasn't gotten one yet. But he looks to be fully in the driver's seat. And there we go. Dark Depths hits the battlefield. He's going to cycle a thicket there. And pass the turn again. So this is trying to set up to make Merit Lage will not have Summoning Sickness on his turn and start crunching. Two turns later, Jarvis, you can be the champion here. There is still the Insect Elaboration.
And there's the Wasteland.
And the Wasteland. So this, again, delaying tactics here, but...
Jarvis actually probably waited so that he had enough mana to port Wasteland and then just be like, does it resolve? Are you going to use it? No? Okay, I'll make a Merit Lage. Yes? Okay, I'll make a Merit Lage in response.
I like that.
I guess he had enough mana because of the Riftstone portal.
Sure.
So.
It's actually kind of interesting how that interaction works out, too. Because, like, Calcano, I think he just stopped attacking at some point, right?
Right.
He's just like, yeah, whatever.
Whatever. You're amazing, you're amazing, my guys, yeah.
Gives him a few extra mana to work with. Probably doesn't matter, but.
It is true that it's more precise to attack.
Yeah. And now Jarvis Yu is going to start going to town on Calcano's mana base here.
Yep.
Uses a Wasteland. I see that he's got a Tabernacle of Pendril Veil in his hand as well. These creatures haven't been a threat for a really long time.
I still think the Needle might be enough if Calcano draws Needle right now.
He's had a lot of draw steps to find it.
Yeah.
You know, Jarvis has been setting up and setting up and setting up, and here he goes. Draws his card for the turn. Finds another gamble.
Looked like exploration.
Is that what that was? Okay.
So he can start wasting twice a turn, or he can combo off every turn.
Jeez, Jarvis is just... He's getting full value out of his
out of everything.
No doubt about it. Look at all those cards in his hand, too. Rashadenport hits the bin. No worries. And he's going to go ahead and port down the Volcanic and pay Exploration. So now he gets to play two lands a turn.
Two Wastelands.
Yep. And here we go. The machine is fully live. How much more can Calcano take here? As he sees his mana base demolished by Jarvis Yu. Jarvis passes a turn back. Draws a card for the turn to Calcano. He's thinking. Jarvis is up a game here. Jarvis going for the slow bleed here, takes a counter off of his dark depths. Life from the Loam's going to get dredged. Recast Life from the Loam. Get back Wastelands plus something else. Yeah, Calcano's fighting the fight here.
You got to do it.
Yeah. He's still alive. He's still at 17. He's still just two attacks away from killing Jarvis. He took out the Punishing Fires with a surgical extraction earlier, but these Mazes of Ith have really been punishing. Oh, no. Now a Tabernacle as well. And the grip tightens here on Christian Calcano. Is it too late now?
It's too late.
The window has passed. It did feel like...
probably like two turns ago.
Maybe a turn and a half, two turns ago.
Maybe three, but...
yeah. But, you know, this is the finals. It's game two.
Oh, I would play until I'm at zero life.
Absolutely.
If I were Calcano.
Absolutely. Passes the turn back still. Yeah, there was that chalice we talked about way back when we were talking about sideboarding, but that feels like a long time ago.
Sure does.
Jarvis,
that was like 15 wastelands ago.
Inching his way towards that trophy. Calcano fighting the good fight here. He's going to force a will, the life from the Loam.
Calcano's about to have no lands, no cards that do anything. I think his hand is a Submergent and Angler.
Mm. So the real question is, how much more can Calcano take here?
Do 15 damage to me, Jarvis.
Yeah. He's going to save two of his creatures and then get his Tropical Island ported down by Jarvis Yu. Calcano passes a turn back to Jarvis. Jarvis is going to dredge Life from the Loam once again. Cast Life from the Loam. Find those wastelands in there somewhere. Oh, geez, three of them.
Yeah.
He can play two lands a turn thanks to Exploration. He's going to waste the wasteland, copy a wasteland. Waste a Trop. He's almost got Calcano down to zero permanence. He's going to have him down to two here. Calcano draws his card for the turn. It's a Brainstorm that he can't currently cast. Calcano says, go for it, man.
I think we're at a point where
is there a mercy rule here?
No, I think Jarvis is intentionally trying to get him to zero permanence and win.
He's going for the flawless victory?
I believe that's what's happening.
Okay. Now that is his prerogative. Let's see. If he can finish off here and in what way he decides to do so. It looks like the Merit Lage token is the way to go.
Yep.
Because right now, Calcano is down to nothing. He draws his card, extends the hand, and Jarvis Yu is our champion. He wins.
Flawless victory.
With lands. Yeah, no permanence on the battlefield there for Calcano as it went. He's having a chat with his buddy, and they're talking about, well, was there any reason I should have gone for it or whatever, but no matter what, Jarvis Yu is our champion.